Bantam Doubleday Dell Audio Publishing presents Star Wars, We Don't Do Weddings, The Band's Tale, a dramatization of the short story by Kathy Tyers.
Where's my fanfare case? Quick, we've got to get out of here.
I don't know. It was next to your music stand.
Quiet!
Shh. You'd better shut up or we'll wake you-know-who.
Sorry, Doink. I know I left it here somewhere.
Jabba the Hutt's smoky presence room stank of spilled intoxicants and sweaty body armor. It was hot on Tatooine, as usual, and Jabba's temp exchanger needed repair, also as usual. Guards and henchmen, dancers and bounty hunters, humans and Jawas all lay where they had toppled, crumpled under arches or piled in semi-private cubicles. On the dais sat the bloated terror himself, burbling as he snored. The presence room's portcullis yawned open. That portcullis bothers me, especially when we want to leave in a hurry. And Figren was taking forever cleaning his crew horn.
Just another all-nighter at Jabba's place, Sandoik.
We've got to split before that core-forsaken inner gate comes down.
You're telling me.
What are you worried about, Naylan? Jabba loves us.
Sure he does. He also likes controlling credit.
And inflicting pain.
Either of which he digs more than anything you play on that clue horn of yours, Figren.
Oh, listen, Jabba's as good a fan as we'll ever get.
We are Figren Dan and the Modal Nodes. Members in good standing of the Intergalactic Federation of Musicians. And we are Jabba the Hutt's exclusive swing band.
Well, I guess it beats having him as an enemy.
I'll grant you that. That's my case.
Shut up.
Shh. Yourself. Tedden, you probably left it down in front.
Knock it off. You're going to get us killed.
I could swear I put it down over here.
Hey, lost and found. Here it is.
Oh.
Slip down behind the stage. Now can we move?
Oh, thanks, Doink.
Fortunately, the fat slug is a sound sleeper. Jabba is the richest crime lord on Tatooine, and he pays us all right. The real problem is, you never know when he's going to decide to flay you, just for fun, or feed you to the Rancor. Jabba's parties are famous all across the Outer Rim territories. He would as soon give up roast bantha as go without his own private band. But I must say, I never thought he had much of an ear for music. In fact, I never spotted his ears at all. His fat, blotchy tail always twitched in rhythm when we played. Only it wasn't our rhythm. It was always his. We are Biff. Our high, hairless craniums manifest a superior evolutionary level, and our mouthfolds pucker into a splendid embouchure for wind instruments. We perceive sounds as precisely as other species perceive color. Back on Clactor 7, there must be 100 small groups as good as the Modal Nodes, but here on Tatooine, we're special, which is why Jabba wouldn't let us out of his clutches. Always one for impressing the guests, that Jabba.
Okay, Biff. Tech, keep your eyes open.
Huh? What?
Doink, give him a hand there, will you?
In a second.
I've got it, Doink. Let's hit the road.
Instruments in hand, we managed to get out of Jabba's presence room without incident and proceeded to the marble entrance hall. Tedden and Ichabel were still arguing over the fanfare cases. I never thought we needed both of them for the music we play, but it's Figren's band and he owns most of the instruments as well. That's because he wins them in friendly little sabacc games.
Watch it!
You know, Figrin, this omnibox is a pain in the neck.
Yeah, but it sounds great.
Oh, you're just
my fizz. You symphonic ridge brows would call it a Durinian Beshnequel, but we do jizz. My fizz slips into a thin case in less time than it takes to roll an Imperial Inspector and check his pockets for credit vouchers. And it's no trouble to carry. Nayland's banfill is cumbersome, and the omnibox, which Tech operates, is a real headache. Tech, who doesn't say much and always has a glazed gleam in his eye, has hated Figrin ever since he won the Omni off him.
Ugh, that's a hut and a half.
Shh, watch your language, Nayland.
State your business.
Figrin, Dan, and the band.
When we reached the outer portcullis, it was down, and I have to say I was worried. A half-dozen Gamorreans lay sleeping around the reception area, but the fourth-class security droid on duty must have been expecting us because he hardly made us wait. He appeared to glower suspiciously, though, as he extended a stubby armature towards the gate lift interlock and the heavy steel grating began to rise.
Come on, Tech. On three. One, two...
Go ahead, Nayland.
Three.
Now, keep close, Ted. I'd like to get home before the first sunrise, if you don't mind.
Outside, it was a little bit cooler, but it looked like the day was going to be a typical Tatooine scorcher.
I'd call that luck.
Go ahead and get Tech into the landspeeder, Doig. I'll put this in back.
We got Nayland and Tech loaded into a cab right away. There probably wouldn't be another one along for hours. Ichabel and Tedden headed off toward their place on foot, lugging their fanfars. Figrin's fanfars, I should say. That left just the two of us standing there, waiting for the next hoverbus. Figrin's sweaty forehead glistened in the moonlight. I clutched my fizz tightly and stared out into the darkness.
Hey, Doik.
Yeah?
I had a shot lip, as humans call it. I was in no mood for foolishness.
Got time for a friendly hand of sabacc?
I don't gamble, Figrin. You know that.
That's why I made you manager, Doig.
A lot of good it does. You never listen to a word I say.
On matters of policy, no. In day-to-day affairs, I trust you completely. Sure you don't want to come into town with me?
Sorry. Gotta go soak my lip.
Figrin brushed the sheen off his head with one knobby hand.
You're thermal, Doig.
And you're compulsive, I wanted to say, but I just said...
I'd rather hang on to my money, Figrin, and my instrument.
I'm the band's straight man, and except for Figrin, perhaps, I'm the only real musician in the lot. I've carried that sweet little fizz through six systems. I peg it when it cracks and lube it when the keys click. I carve my own reeds. I wasn't betting it on any sabacc match, not even to placate fiery Figrin Dan, a band leader who criticizes every missed note, owns everybody else's instrument, and isn't shy about giving orders.
I still say you're thermal, Doig.
All musicians are thermal.
You're thermal for a musician. Who ever heard of a bander who didn't gamble?
I don't gamble, Figrin. You know that...
A smoky silhouette emerged from behind Jabba's palace and began rolling along the pavement in our direction. The droid's wasp waist and squared-off head were immediately recognizable.
Figrin, turn around. Slowly.
Huh? Wyatt's...
Right. E-522. And he's not wearing a restraining bolt.
He's coming for us. Why'd you have to get him in trouble with Jabba, Doik?
I didn't mean to. Run! Wait a minute. He hasn't started firing at us yet.
And you know what they say about assassin droids. Never worry about one you can see.
Early morning greetings, Figrin Dan, Doik Nath.
Greetings, E-522.
Don't be alarmed.
Huh? Look out, Doik!
The droid raised his upper limbs. Both ended at elbow joints. Somebody had disengaged his business parts, but that probably didn't leave him helpless. Assassin droids carry backup.
All of my weapons have been removed.
Really?
Nice to hear it.
My assassination programming has been erased as well.
All for the best, buddy.
I can confirm that for my part. My new employer saved me from deconstruction by using me this way.
You mean you're not working for Jabba anymore?
That is correct, Doik Nath. After he fed me to the Rancor, in your place, as you doubtless recall...
Wait a minute. Some of your memory must have been erased as well. That human falsely accused me of eating freckled toads out of Jabba's private snack tank.
That is true.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.